The fantasy baseball season, and here's a few pitches I would sell high and trade away this week. The first guy's Carlos Rodon of the Chicago White Sox. So Rodon here, he threw a no-hitter last week in a great ball game he pitched, no doubt about it, versus the Cleveland Indians. And then he pitched in last night's game once again at Cleveland. So right now on the season, Rodon, he's ranked 30th in fantasy baseball, 19 innings pitched, a 3-0 record, 5 hits given up, only 1 earned run, 1 homer, 8 walks, 24 strikeouts, an 0.47 ERA, and an 0.68 whip with 1 quality start. So Rodon, like I said, his value's at an all-time high after coming off the no-hitter last week versus the Cleveland Indians, and then a decent game yesterday where he got the win. So the first 3 games of the season for Rodon, April 5th at Seattle, 5 innings, got the win, 2 hits, 3 walks, 9 strikeouts, a 1 whip. Then April 14th, a no-hitter versus Cleveland, got the win, obviously, 7 strikeouts and the quality start and no whip. And then yesterday at Cleveland, it was a mediocre game once again for Rodon, 5 innings, 1 win, 3 hits, 1 earned run, 5 walks, 8 strikeouts, a 1.80 ERA, and a 1.60 whip. So right now, in 2 out of the 3 starts, Rodon, he's been pretty wild, and he's only gone 5 innings. So right now, if I was a Rodon owner, I definitely would sell him high here after the no-hitter and him off to a good start so far this season at 3-0, because I don't think he's going to sustain it. And we've seen him be wild 2 out of the 3 first starts. And yes, it was great to see him get a no-hitter, but right now, while his value's at a pretty much peak value where it's going to be all season, I would trade Rodon here. The second play is Mark Melancon, the closer for the San Diego Padres. So Melancon, he was a late offseason signing here for San Diego. And right now, he's off to an amazing start, is Melancon on the season. He's ranked 21st in fantasy baseball, 9 innings pitched, 6 saves, 3 hits, 1 earned run, 7 strikeouts, a 1 ERA, and an 0.33 whip. So right now, closer, it's pretty much a crapshoot. I always say this in each and every video, pretty much, after the first 5-10 closes. But Melancon, he was a player drafted later in most fantasy drafts, the 15th round or later. And right now, he's one of the best closers, off the best closer in fantasy baseball. And right now, we know the Padres are going to win a lot of games this season. Them and the Dodgers, most likely the 2 best teams in the National League. And Melancon, he easily could get a 30 to 35 save season if he stays healthy, obviously, and doesn't implode. But right now, he's been lights out. And if I could trade Melancon for a good hitter or a decent starting pitcher, this is the time to do it while he's up there in saves at the leaderboard in the majors. And yeah, he's going to get the saves, but I don't think he's going to stay with a low ERA all season. And he's a veteran up there that easily could break down. So right now, while his value's up, he's a play I definitely will look to sell high. The next pitcher is Steven Matz of the Toronto Blue Jays. So Steven Matz, he's doing things people expected from him years ago when he came up from the minor leagues with the New York Mets as one of their top prospects. But a change of scenery has really been beneficial this season so far for Matz. And on the season, he's ranked 53rd in fantasy baseball, 18 and a third innings, a 3-0 record, 9 hits, 3 earned runs, only 1 home run, 6 walks, 18 strikeouts, and it comes out to a 1.47 ERA and an 0.82 whip with 3 quality starts. So Steven Matz, he's been impressive, no doubt about it, and he's pitching well, but so far he's had pretty decent matchups as well to go in his favor, with 2 matchups versus, 1 matchup versus Texas and the other versus Kansas City. But the real test will be for Matz in 2 nights at Tampa Bay on April 23rd. But I can't take anything away from Matz. He's living up to the hype he should have had, like I said, a few seasons ago with the Mets. And the first few starts were April 5th at Texas, 6 1/3. Got the win in that one. 2 hits, 1 earned run, 1 walk, 9 strikeouts, a 1.42 ERA, and an 0.47 whip with a quality start. April 10th versus the Angels. Got the win, 6 innings, 5 hits, 1 earned run, gave up a homer, 3 walks, 4 strikeouts, 0.50 ERA, and a 1.33 whip with a quality start. April 17th at Kansas City, 6 innings, got the win, 2 hits, 1 earned run, 2 walks, 5 strikeouts, a 1.50 ERA, and an 0.67 whip with a quality start. So Steven Matz, he's pitching lights out, no doubt about it. But right now, I think it's going to fall out for Matz. I've seen too much of him over the last few seasons with a lot of Met games on. and he just would get bomb early in the games, or if something didn't go his way, it would just unravel, and he would give up a lot of home runs, as Matt. So far this season, he's changed it up, and he's pitched very well. But right now, while his value's at an all-time peak, I would trade him, because I just don't think it's going to be sustainable as he versus better teams, especially in the AL East, as the season goes on. The next pitch is Corbin Burnes of the Milwaukee Brewers. We saw Burnes last season have a monster year, and so far this season, he's off to an amazing start, ranked fourth in fantasy baseball, 24 and a third inning, 2-1 record, 8 hits only given up, 1 earned run, 1 homer, 40 strikeouts, which is amazing, an 0.37 ERA, an 0.33 whip, and 4 quality starts in his first 4 starts. So Corbin Burnes, I thought last season he was a flash in the pan, a one-hit wonder, but obviously I was wrong so far on the season, where he's having an amazing year, especially with 40 strikeouts and 24 in a third innings here for this Milwaukee Brewer team. So the last few starts for him, April 8th at St. Louis, 6 innings, 1 hit, 9 strikeouts, an 0.17 ERA in a quality start. 14th versus the Chicago Cubs, 6 innings, got the win in that one, 2 hits, 10 strikeouts, an 0.33 whip and a quality start, and no runs given up. And then last night at San Diego, another masterpiece here for Corbin Burnes. 6 innings, got the win, 4 hits, 10 strikeouts, no earned runs again, an 0.67 whip and a quality start. So Corbin Burnes, what could I say? Right now, his value is at an all-time high, and this might be the highest it will be all season at number 4. So if you could get a big slugger or even 2 mediocre starting pitchers for him in a trade, this is the time to do it, because I think he'll still be solid as Burnes, but no way his ERA is going to be under a 1, and his strikeout rate, I think, will calm down just a bit, even though he's on a crazy pace right now with 40 of them in 4 starts. But right now, if there's the right trade out there, you definitely go out there and make it, because I don't think Burnes is going to be this crazy of an ace this season. And the 5th and final pitcher I would look to sell high or trade away is Joe Musgrove of the San Diego Padres. Musgrove, he was on the list last week, and once again, he's making it this week. He threw a no-hitter last week, was Musgrove, and he's been a great pitcher, no doubt about it. But another guy, while his value's at a super high pace, I don't think he's going to sustain these numbers the rest of the season. On the season, 54th ranked in fantasy baseball, 26 innings, a 2-2 record, 11 hits, 3 earned runs, 3 homers he's given up, 3 walks, 37 strikeouts, 0.04 ERA, an 0.50 whip, and 3 quality starts for Musgrove. So right now, he's striking out a lot of batters. In the last 3 games, he struck out 29 batters as Musgrove. So that's very impressive, no doubt about it. And the first 4 starts of the season are pretty good, except his April 14th start at the Pittsburgh Pirates, his former team. April 3rd versus Arizona, 6 innings, got the win, 3 hits, 8 strikeouts, no ERA, an 0.50 whip, and a quality start. April 9th, where he threw the no-hitter at Texas, 9 innings, obviously got the win, 10 strikeouts. And then April 14th at Pittsburgh, a little bit of a downhill game it was for him. 4 innings, got the loss, 4 hits, only 1 earned run in that one, 2 walks, 6 strikeouts, a 2.25 ERA, and a 1.50 whip. And then versus the Milwaukee Brewers a few nights ago, 7 innings, got the loss in that one, 4 hits, 2 earned runs, 2 homers, 1 walk, a whopping 13 strikeouts, and 2.57 ERA, 0.71 whip, and a quality start. So those are great numbers for Musgrove. But right now, I just don't think he's going to sustain this crazy amount of numbers. I know he's on a great San Diego Padre team. The wins, they're definitely going to be great for him. But the ERA, I don't see it staying in the low ones or mid ones or even the twos. Last season, he was a 3.86 with Pittsburgh, and this season I think his numbers will be about mid 3 to 4 when it's all said and done. So right now, while his value is at an all-time high, this is the perfect time to trade him off, and I'm sure you could get a good bat, or like I said, the same thing with Burnes, 2 good quality starters for him in a deal. So that's a few pitchers I would look to trade away here and sell high in week 3 of the fantasy baseball season.